Hey guys, so today's video is going to be about me getting ready for prom. So I'm just gonna like take you through kind of what I do to get ready. I've already eaten breakfast and exercised and washed my hair and everything, so that's good. And right now it's about 12 p.m. so I'm probably going to go eat some lunch and then we will start getting ready.
We realized at the last minute my shoes were not fitting correctly, so we had to go to the store and buy some new ones. I would not recommend waiting to the last minute.
Okay, hey guys, so I just finished lunch. It's about 2 p.m. right now, and it's kind of late, but it's okay. I can hurry, it'll be okay. And now I just have to go blow dry my hair because in the back it's pretty wet still, so I can't really do anything with wet hair, so I'm gonna go blow dry it and do my hair and makeup. So let's go. I'm gonna section off my hair and then probably try to curl it. So we'll see how this goes. So I'm just going to just kind of pull it back like a half ponytail. And then I'm gonna take this clip and then just secure it like that. That's kind of out of my face and I can just work on these pieces of hair. And I'm not really sure what kind of curl I'm looking for. So I'm just gonna kind of experiment and see what works. Just start in the back just so that I can move those curls to and put over my shoulder when I'm done. Let's see, I'm gonna do like smaller pieces. Middle piece. So just nice, really loose curls. And I like to leave a good piece just uncurled and it kind of looks more natural that way. So I just leave it and then I curl away from my face. Yeah, like that. I'm gonna try one way going like this and see how it works. Yeah, that one didn't curl as well. So I think I'm just gonna do what I've been doing. But it's a nice kind of wave. Now I'm going to move on to the other side and just repeat the same process. I kind of just go with whatever feels right. I'm not too picky about my curls, honestly. I just like to curl away from my face, but that's pretty much it. If they aren't looking the way I want them to, then I'll just redo them. But really, it has to be pretty bad for me to redo it. So this is the bottom section and I'm not going to really loosen them at all because they will loosen on their own. So I'm just going to leave it and then move on to the top.
So I kind of just wanted to pop in here and just talk about prom and just all the fakeness of it. I just was thinking, like, you know, you don't really need a date. You don't have to have a date. I just wanted to say this because a lot of people feel like they need to, but really you can just go with a group of friends or go by yourself and it's really fun. So trust me when I say you do not need a guy to make you feel special or loved, because you are loved by so many. You're loved by me for sure, even though I don't really know you. Just know that you are not defined by how you look or anything like that. It's really just all about having fun and being yourself.
I kind of do like a combination of regular like curling with the barrel and then using it as like a wand, so you can kind of like mix it up, and I think it looks decent. We'll see how this turns out. I think it'll turn out okay. I'm slightly nervous, but I think it'll be okay. See there, that one turned out a lot better. So this is the bottom part, and now I'm going to do the top section.
So I really enjoyed doing my hair this day. I loved the wand method where I just wrap it around the barrel. It really gave it these really cool like waves almost. And oh my goodness, this one right here. Whoa, look at that. That is like so curly. I love it, and it's just very natural looking, which I'm really about. I don't like those super tight curls, so this was really perfect.
I found a stray piece!
This is how the hair turned out. I really highly recommend that you try this kind of method out. It really worked and ended up looking very natural, especially when I let it kind of loosen out over time. You should definitely try this hairstyle out.
I think this is gonna have to do for my hair right now. I'll probably ask my sister or my mom to look and make sure that there's no stray pieces.
Okay, so for my makeup, first I'm gonna be taking this Clinique concealer, and I'm just going to apply it to any reddish spots or any spots that look kind of dark. For me, I will just put it like here around my nose and probably some on my cheeks, and I'll do that before I put on some base. Okay, so now I've applied concealer to the areas that I want, and it's not super blended as you can see. It's kind of like you can tell where I put it, but that's okay because we're gonna smooth it out with some base. I'm just using this base right here, and I'm gonna just use as least amount as I can because I don't want my face to be super cakey looking. So I'm just gonna take a little bit on my finger and just kind of dab and put dots on my face, and then I'm gonna take this blending sponge and just kind of blend it onto my cheek. Okay, so now I'm pretty much done with my like skin on the outside. I'm pretty much done just, you know, touching up areas. I'll probably add blush and stuff like later, but now I'm going to move on to my eyes, and I'm just gonna start with doing eyeliner. I know you can do either eyeshadow or eyeliner first, but I like to do eyeliner because if I mess up, I can, you know, use a makeup wipe, and then I don't have to erase all my hard work for the eyeshadow. So I'm just going to do a little bit of a liquid liner. This is the Neutrogena Precision liquid eyeliner, and I got it just at Walmart, and yeah, so I'm going to do that now.
So I apologize for the not so great angle here, but really what I'm doing is I'm just taking the liquid liner from the inner corner of my eye and then extending it all the way to the outer corner, and then extending that a little bit further with like a little bit of a wing or just lengthening it. And you can get creative with the angle you do this at, but I kind of just did it more straight and then a little bit upward, and that's what I did here.
Okay, so here's how the eyeliner turned out. I try to make it as like even as possible. So all I did at the very end, I didn't show this, but I just kind of connected the bottom part to the wing a little bit on both sides, and then just brought it in a little bit, and then tried to make them look somewhat even. It's okay if they're not exact. Sometimes the mascara and the eyeshadow help with that. So for the eyeshadow, I'm just using this little thing from Clinique. This is not sponsored or anything. I just really love their makeup, and there are two shades, the purple, pinkish, and then the brown. So I will be using both of these, and I am going to start by putting a light coat of the pink on both of my eyelids. Let's do this. I like to close my eye because sometimes the powder gets in my eye and then my eye gets very irritated, so that's not good. And just a nice light coat. I usually do like 3 times on each just to get it. You want it to be noticeable, but not completely, you know, wild. It's very light. It's just a nice base kind of to have on your eyelids, I think. I just like to kind of blend it with my middle finger just to make it more with the rest of my face and not so colored. It just looks better if it's blended a bit, because there's nothing worse than unblended eyeshadow. And then I'm gonna take that darker shade and then just apply a little bit to the corners. And it looks really dark right now, but I'm going to blend it and it will look better in a second. So now I'm just gonna take my finger, just kind of smooth it and just kind of put a little bit more at the corner, like that. And then same for this side, I'm gonna use my finger, kind of blend it so they mix the colors a little bit, and then a little bit more on the corners. And then I try to look and make sure that it's somewhat even, and I think it is, to clean up a little bit there. That was eyeliner. I'm just gonna go in with some more pink and really make it pink, because pink is so pretty. You want to see it. Otherwise, I don't want it to look like I'm not wearing any, but at the same time, you don't want so little that you can barely tell. Just putting it on pretty generously. And I really like this shade because it's very subtle, but it's very beautiful at the same time. There we go. I think that's good. And now I'm just going to probably put some lip stuff on, maybe a little blush, and then should be good to go. And then we'll get ready into my dress. Okay, I also forgot, I'm using mascara as well. This is Neutrogena's mascara, and I'm just going to pretty generously apply this. My eyelashes are surprisingly somewhat long, but I like to add some more to them. And I do the top and the bottom. I don't know how much the bottom does, but why not? And then I'm just probably gonna clean up the little mess that I made on my cheek over here and then put some blush on. Here's the final look, and I'll probably do my lips last. Also, I like to set things with like a little powder. I just have this little pad thing, so I just pat it down and then just put it over my cheeks. Just kind of helps to set what I did with the base and stuff. This isn't like super necessary, but it kind of feels like it gives me a little bit more coverage. And that's it. So this is my dress. It's so beautiful. I really love how it looks, and it's very tasteful, very formal looking, and I really love the flowers. I love red, so that was really a good find for me. And yeah, I was super happy that I got to wear it twice, once to play a violin solo and second time for prom. I'm just eating this really quick before I leave. It's just tuna and some spinach and then a little bit of a dressing with red wine vinegar and avocado oil. So I'm gonna eat this really quick and then we gotta go. Yes.
So I didn't really get a chance to record much of prom, but I did get some really cute pictures with my friends, and it was just a really fun time to hang out and just see each other all dressed up, and it was just a really fun night.
So I'm now back from prom. It was so fun. And this is how my hair held up. It actually turned out really nicely.
just letting it naturally fall out, gave it these really nice waves. So I highly recommend like try it this and just see how you like it. And yeah, and here's my makeup. It still stayed pretty well and everything like that. And so now I'm just going to get unready for the little after party. I'm just gonna wear some really comfortable clothing and yeah.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And I just want to say thank you so much to everyone who's already subscribed to my channel. It means so much to me. So I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.